Hello, my dear students. This is your history teacher, Mrs. Rinki Singh Yadav. Today, we will begin with the Civics Chapter 1, that is the Constitution of India. So, the Constitution means Samvidhan. India, Bharat. Bharat ka Samvidhan. What are the topics we are going to cover in this chapter? The meaning of constitution, beginning of a new era, the constituent assembly, the preamble, objectives of the constitutions, fundamental rights and fundamental duties. We need rules and regulations to lead an organized social life. We have certain rules and codes to be able to perform purposeful activities. Similarly, rules are essentials for governing a country. So when we have to have an organized social life, we need certain rules and regulations. Take an example of your home. So there will be certain rules and regulation at your home, that at what time you have to get up, what time you have your breakfast, and what time you take bath, then what time when you will have your lunch, when you study, when you go for playing, when you watch TV. Okay, so everything, there is certain rules at your home. If you are not doing so, you cannot have an organized life. If you go on sleeping, you might be getting late for your schools. You may miss your, if you are getting late for your schools, you may get scolding from your teachers or from your principal. Okay. If you go on playing, you will never study, and in your future, you will never become what you want to be. Okay, so for that you need a rules and regulation. And if we have certain rules and codes to have a perform purposeful activities. Okay, similarly, rules are essential for governing a country also. So there have to be certain rules when you govern your country. Like, there is a traffic rules. Okay, so red light, your yellow light and green light. Okay, so if these light or traffic police are not there, there may be the possibility of accidents. Okay, so for that you have to, for governing a country in a smooth manners, you have certain rules. All modern states have their constitutions. So here state means countries. Okay, state means countries. Okay, so all modern countries, if we take an example of any modern country, if you talk about India, talk about USA, talk about UK, all these countries, all these states have their constitutions. Government and administrations are now run according to the defined rules and procedures and not according to the individual ideas. Okay, so what is there in the constitutions? There are certain rules and regulations are written in the constitutions. Okay, and government and the administrations has to run according to the defined rules and procedures given in the constitutions. The government code and administration, okay, they have to run according to the rules and procedures which are given, which are written in the constitution, okay, and not according to any individual ideas. So we cannot run any country on an individual idea. For example, if we take an example of our country, we live in a multi-religion country. Okay, and suppose we have a like Hindu government in in center or in any reason. And if a particular person is running the place according to their own religion, you cannot satisfy other religion also. You have to satisfy other religion as well. Okay, because we are living in a multi-religion country. So we have to look after the needs of all the religion, not an individual religion. India is governing with a base of Indian constitution, which reflect the faith and aspiration of people of India. So India is governing with a base of an Indian constitution, which shows, which reflect the faith and aspiration of people of India. Okay. So Indian constitution mein kya hai? The faith and aspiration of people of India. Okay. We have lot of faith in our constitution. Every individual of India has a faith in their constitution that it will not do any partiality against any religion, any caste, any creed, any race, any person. They cannot cannot be biased, okay, against any particular person. So every citizen has a faith in the Indian constitution. It is a supreme law of the land. Okay, this is the supreme law. Ye ek sabse upar hai constitutions har kisi se upar hai. It's even above any government, any president, any prime minister, anyone. It is above all the, it is the supreme law of the land. Even the parliament cannot override the constitution. Even parliament, who are they? We have the people which are elected by the people of India. Parliament mein kaun hota hai? The leaders which are elected by the people of India. Okay, if we talk about our India, so even these people cannot override the constitution. They have to follow according to the constitution. Whatever is written in the constitution, they have to go along with the constitution. Now, what is the meaning of constitution? The meaning of constitution. Constitution is a document which contains details of how to govern our country. तो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में क्या है, एक डॉक्यूमेंट है, ये रिटन डॉक्यूमेंट है हमारे भारत का, विच कंटेन डिटेल, जिसमें डिटेल है किसके बारे में, हाउ टू गवर्न अवर कंट्री, किस तरीके से हमें अपने कंट्री को गवर्न करना है, राज करना है कंट्री के ऊपर. एंड इट इज़ अ फ्रेमवर्क विद इन विच अ गवर्नमेंट हैज टू फंक्शन. ये एक फ्रेमवर्क है जिसके अकॉर्डिंग गवर्नमेंट को फंक्शन करना, दे हैव टू रन अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस फ्रेमवर्क. इट डिफाइंस द पावर्स एंड द फंक्शंस ऑफ डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एंड ऑल्सो इनमरेट्स the fundamental rights and fundamental duties of citizens. Our constitution explains our national goals like democracy, socialism, secularism, liberty, equality, fraternity, etc. Thus, our constitution has an importance of its own and we must show our respect to it. So, in the previous line, what is it written? It shows, it define, ये define करता है power, okay, and functions also, कि किसके पास कितनी power है और उसके क्या functions हैं, और किसके function और power है, functions of the organs of government and also organs of government. Like it's a central government, it's a state government, it can be administration, your IAS, IPS. So these all come under these the organs, and they define the power and function of these organs. And also enumerate the fundamental rights and fundamental duties of citizen. It's not only include the organs of the government, ये सिर्फ गवर्नमेंट को नहीं इंक्लूड करता है या ऑर्गन्स जो गवर्नमेंट की ऑर्गन है उनको ही सिर्फ इंक्लूड नहीं करता है. इट ऑल्सो गिव द फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज टू द सिटीजन ऑल्सो. इसमें सिटीजन्स के लिए भी फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज दे रखी हैं. अगर आपके अधिकार हैं तो उसके साथ साथ आपके कुछ कर्तव्य भी हैं अपने देश के लिए. दिस इज ऑल्सो रिटन इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. Our constitution explains our national goals. Constitutions explain करता है कि हमारे national goal क्या हैं, हमारे भारत के national goal क्या हैं. It is democracy, socialism, secularism, liberty, equality and fraternity. Thus, our constitution has an importance on its own and we must show respect to our constitution. Okay. Hope everything is clear till now. Now, next topic in this is beginning of a new era. So, when and why this constitution has been made? Okay. On 26 January 1950, we begin to govern ourselves according to the rules framed by our own elected representatives. So, who made this constitution? Who wrote this constitution? This was written by our own elected representatives. Okay. And this was the time of 26 January 1950. A few years after when the India got independence. Okay. We all know that India got independence in 15th of August 1947. Okay. So, we took little time to frame our constitutions because we had to face a lot of problem after independence. So it took time to frame a constitution, and then our elected representatives framed some rules for us. The constitution was enforced on this day. Okay, so on 26 January 1950, this constitution was enforced. This day is celebrated with great joy and is one of our national festival. Okay, so this day, earlier this day was, this day 26 January is celebrated with great joy and is one of our national festival. 26 January we all know, okay, it's a Republic Day. Okay, before independence, our country was governed by the rules framed by the British. We did not have power even on matters that concerned us. Right to vote was given to a few selected adults. Thus, after independence, a constitution was framed for the country. So, we all know that even we were the citizen of our country. And when Britishes were governing us, we cannot have power to talk about the matters which were concerned to us. Even the right to vote, okay, which is a fundamental right of us, is also given to very few people. Okay, today we all know that every person who is having the age in 18 or above 18, they have right to vote. Okay, but earlier it was not so. So only few people were getting the opportunity to right to vote. Thus, after the independence, constitution for framed for the country. Now the constituent assembly. Our constitution was framed by the constituent assembly. So who framed this constitution? Which body was after it? It was the constituent assembly. Constituent assembly framed the constitution. The constituent assembly had a wide ranging representation. A majority of members, okay, so just you can see this picture. This is our former president, Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Okay. So majority of members belonged to the Indian National Congress and other political parties. So constituent assembly में कौन कौन था? It belonged to the Indian. उस समय सबसे पहली जो political party थी that was the Indian National Congress. Okay, and some other also political parties. And the prominent members were Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Maulana Azad, Sir Tej Bahadur Sapru, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and others. So these are very prominent members of this Constituent Assembly. Okay. Weaker sections and minorities were also represented. Okay, because in India we were having weaker sections also, some minorities also. For example, we take Christians, we have Parsis. Okay, they were in the minorities, very very limited population was there, and weaker sections like your scheduled caste. Okay, so they comes under the weaker sections. So they were also there, the people also represented of from this section also. There were 30 scheduled caste members, okay, scheduled caste members. Frank Anthony and Dr. H.P. Modi represented the Anglo-Indians and Parsis respectively. So Frank Anthony, he was Anglo-Indian, means half European and half Indian, and the Parsis, H.P. Modi representing the Parsis community. There were also women members like Sarojini Naidu and Vijaya Lakshmi Pandit. Even the they were the represented from the women's side also. That is the Sarojini Naidu and Vijaya Lakshmi Pandit. So these all members, the members were the Constituent Assembly. The next topic in this is the Drafting Committee. On 29th August 1947, the Assembly appointed a drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar to prepare a draft of the Constitution. It had 7 other members. Okay, so on 29th August 1948, so 15th August, a few days later, the Assembly appointed drafting committee. Assembly was made, the Constituent Assembly was made, and this assembly appointed a drafting committee under the chairmanship of, who was the chairman? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, to prepare the draft of the Constitution. And it had how many other, it had 7 other members also. So totally 8 members were there. Okay, there is a green box in this. Shri Rajagopalachari took over from Lord Mountbatten as a Governor General of India. So we all know that earlier, when the time of the Britishers, we were having no president or nothing, Prime Minister. We were having the Governor General of India from the British side. So after leaving, who was the last Governor General from the British was the Lord Mountbatten, and after him an Indian who was Sri Rajagopalachari, he became as a Governor General of India. Thus, he became the first Indian Governor General of India and held office till January 26, 1950. Because till then, we had not given our India the constitution. So, when Dr. Rajendra Prasad became the, when and after this, we Dr. Rajendra Prasad became the first president of our country. Now, why this drafting committee was made? Okay, and why this, it took so lot of your time to form the constitution. Matlab 29th August 1947 se drafting committee bana, aur uske baad 26 January 1950 mein humne jaakar apne aap ko ek constitution diya. Because they had studied so many constitutions from other part of the world also. Okay, these people, this drafting committee members, they have studied lot of constitution of other countries. They have studied the constitution of US, UK, आयरलैंड, सो मेनी कंट्रीज, एंड दे हैव यू नो टेकन गुड गुड थिंग्स फ्रॉम देयर कंट्री, जो हमारे हमारे इंडिया के कंट्री में सूटेबल हो सकते थे. तो वहाँ से उन्होंने इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स उठाए और अपने कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में डाले जो हमारे लिए, हमारे देश के लिए, हमारे देश के लोगों के लिए बेनिफिट हो सकता था. तो दैट वॉज द रीज़न दे हैव यू नो दे हैव लुक्ड आफ्टर एवरी पॉइंट, सो इट शुड नॉट डिस्क्रिमिनेट एनी पर्सन इन इंडिविजुअल इन अवर कंट्री. So this is the little bit the signature of some of the you know founders of the Constitution of India. The important members of the committee were Sri N. Gopala Swami in Iyengar, Sri Aladi Krishna Swami Iyer, Sri K. M. Munsi, and Sri Sayyid Muhammad Sadullah. Okay. So you can see the picture of your first Prime Minister of India, that is the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He is, as you know, signing the constitution. Now, very important, okay. So in this, some provision of the constitutions were immediately put into effect, but the constitution as a whole came into force with effect from January 26, 1950. So some provision, kuch provision jo the wo immediately effect mein aa gaye, but the constitution as a whole, jo constitution abhi hum padhte hain, as a whole was put into effect from January 26, 1950 only. Okay. सो नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज द प्रीएम्बल. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होता है. दिस इज द फर्स्ट पेज ऑफ योर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. दिस इज हाउ इट लुक्स व्हेन यू ओपन एनी व्हेन यू रीड एनी कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, किसी भी अच्छे राइटर का आप कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया आप उठाकर देखेंगे, दिस इज द फर्स्ट पेज ऑफ योर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड इट इज द सोल ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. इसमें आपका सब कुछ आ जाता है, मतलब पूरा. अगर इफ आई टॉक अबाउट दैट टुडे इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन देयर आर 448 आर्टिकल्स. ओके, 448 आर्टिकल्स हैं इस समय. ऑलमोस्ट यू नो 500 आर्टिकल्स आर ऑलमोस्ट 450 आर्टिकल्स आर देयर. 450 आर्टिकल बहुत बड़ी बात होती है. एंड दोज ऑल आर्टिकल वी कैन इफ वी टॉक अबाउट कि सब सारे आर्टिकल को उठाकर आप इस एक पेज में समराइज कर सकते हो. ऑल आर्टिकल्स आर समराइज इन दिस वन. Now, what this preambles talk about? What does it say? We, the people of India, we, who are we? We are the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a. So, we take our, you know, oath that we constitute India, we make India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all citizens, and we are telling all citizens that they are secure in justice, which is social, economic, and political liberty of thought. You have liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constitution Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution. We will one by one study about these points. Okay, what does sovereign means? What does socialist means? We will study one by one. Okay, so you know this, and why these terms are used, sovereign, socialist, you know, because when we were under the British rule, we were not given justice. The Indian people were not given justice. They were not having the liberty. They cannot speak. If they were tortured also, they cannot speak about it. Okay, they were not having any expression of thought. कुछ नहीं बोल सकते थे, अपने ही देश में एक बंदी की तरह थे. सो दिस इज द रीजन दैट अवर इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव हैव गिवन अवर इंडिया दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो एवरी सिटीजन हैव द यू नो दे कैन एक्सेस टू ऑल दीज टर्म्स, सोवरेन, सोशलिस्ट, सेक्युलर, डेमोक्रेटिक, रिपब्लिक. ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट इज इन प्रीएम्बल. नाउ the preamble, the constitution of India, like many other democratic constitutions, is preceded by a preamble. So constitution India baki aur democratic constitution ki tarah is preceded, started by a preamble. The preamble is an introduction of the constitution. Okay, सो इफ़ यू टॉक अबाउट, हम जब कभी स्टोरी पढ़ते हैं सो उसका स्टार्टिंग में एक इंट्रोडक्शन दे रखा होता है, सेम वे इज लाइक दैट. ओके, सो प्रियम्बल इज एन इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. द प्रियम्बल टू अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन समराइज एज इट्स एम्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. ओके, प्रियम्बल क्या है टू अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन? इट समराइजेज हमारे, क्या समराइज कर रहा है? हमारे एम क्या है, हमारे देश के प्रति हमारा एम क्या है, हमारे देश के लोगों के प्रति हमारा एम क्या है, हमारे ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है. द प्रियम्बल एक्सप्रेसेस अ ग्रेट डील ऑफ मीनिंग इन फ्यू वर्ड्स. ओके, तो बहुत ही कम शब्दों में आपके 448 आर्टिकल इसमें आ जाते हैं. ओके, सो इट्स ग्रेट डील ऑफ मीनिंग इन फ्यू वर्ड्स. द प्रियम्बल इंडिकेट्स द नेचर एंड आइडियल्स ऑफ द स्टेट एंड ऑल्सो द अल्टीमेट सोर्स ऑफ अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रियम्बल, दैट इज सोवरेन, सोशलिस्ट, सेक्युलर, डेमोक्रेटिक रिपब्लिक, सेट्स अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. ऑफ द स्टेट एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट, justice, liberty, equality and fraternity, represent the ideals of the state or what is desirable. It also tells us to what type of political and economic order the country should have. Okay, so the first democratic socialist, ye sab kya bata rahe hain? Objective bata rahe hain ki hamara object kya hai. And सेकेंड पार्ट, जस्टिस, लिबर्टी, इक्वालिटी, इट शोज द आइडियल्स वॉट इज डिजायरेबल, हमारा डिजायर क्या है, हम क्या करना चाहते हैं. इट ऑल्सो टेल्स अस टू वॉट टाइप ऑफ पॉलिटिकल एंड इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर शुड बी देयर इन द कंट्री. किस तरीके का पॉलिटिकल एंड इकोनॉमिक इन्वायरमेंट होना चाहिए एक कंट्री में. ओके, द ओपनिंग वर्ड्स, We the people of India have got a special significance of their own. These words affirm that the constitution has the will of the people behind it. So ye shabd, we the people of India, it tells that what is the its significance is that it has the will of the people. Yahan logon ki ichhaen batai ja rahi hain ki hum भारत के लोग क्या चाहते हैं. विल ऑफ द पीपल एंड पीपल आर इट्स सोर्स एंड स्ट्रेंथ. इट वॉज ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया दैट देयर इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स फ्रेम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस. ओके, सम ऑफ द फीचर्स ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस आर देयर. ओके, इट इज़ अ रिटन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. समटाइम्स सम कंट्रीज आर हैविंग नॉट दे आर नॉट हैविंग रिटन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यूनाइटेड किंगडम, दे आर नॉट हैविंग रिटन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. हमारे पास बुक है, रिटन में है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, लेकिन उनके पास रिटन में नहीं है. द लॉन्गेस्ट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, इट्स हमारा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दुनिया का सबसे लंबा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन है. अ ब्लेंड ऑफ रिजिडिटी एंड फ्लैक्सीबिलिटी, हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में रिजिडनेस भी है, किसी कुछ चीज़ें आप बिल्कुल चेंज नहीं कर सकते हो, सम थिंग्स यू कैन चेंज, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज देयर. फेडरल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, दिस वी विल टॉक, दैट इज वी हैव अ प्रेसिडेंट. सिंगल सिटीजनशिप, हमारे यहाँ सिंगल सिटीजनशिप है, दैट इज ओनली द इंडियन सिटीजनशिप. दो वी आर हैविंग स्टेट्स बट वी आर नॉट गिविंग द स्टेट सिटीजनशिप, वी आर गिविंग ओनली सिंगल सिटीजनशिप. फॉर टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ US is having two citizenship. One is of the US and another one is of the state. For example, if one person is living in Colorado, they will have this citizenship of the Colorado also. And amendments, there are certain changes in the, if you want to change something in the constitution, then you can have to amend it. Certain changes can be made in parts of the constitution if required through a procedure called amendments. So today we'll wrap up this chapter. We will continue. Till then, keep learning and be safe. Thank you.